Good morning all. Today's topic is Bangor's algorithm. Because of time constraint, I'll explain half of the algorithm here, the remaining in the next video. So all of you go through these two videos. Example of Bangor's algorithm. See, here I have five process. P0 to P5, five process are there. And three resource type. Resource type names are A, B, C. And total available of A is 10, B is 5, C is 7. Okay, the snapshot of at time T0. Like at time T0, what is the condition? So there are five process. A, B, C are the three resources. Maximum A is 10. Total A is 10, total B is 5, total C is 7. Out of that, P0 allocated with only 1B. And maximum P0 required 7A, 5B, 3C. So need of P0 is, need already I explained in the last video how to calculate need. Max minus allocation. So 7 minus 0 is 7, 5 minus 1 is 4, 3 minus 0 is 3. P1 allocated with 2A, 0B, 0C. Maximum P1 required 3A, 2B, 2C. So the need of P1 is 3 minus 2 is 1, 2 minus 0 is 2, 2 minus 0 is 2. P2. P2 allocated with 3A, 0B, 2C. And maximum it required 9A, 0B, 2C. So need is 9 minus 3, 6, 0, 0. And like that, P0, P3. P3 allocated with 2A, 1B, 1C. Maximum P3 required 2A, 2B, 2C. And they need 0, 1B, 1C. P4 allocated with only 2C. And they required maximum 4A, 3B, 3C. So the need is 4 minus 0 is 4. 3 minus 0 is 3. 3 minus 2 is 1. And currently available resources. The third column indicates currently available resources. See, total 10 instances of A was there, right? Out of 10, how many allotted? 0 plus 2 plus 3 plus 2 allotted. So 7 is allotted, right? So 10 minus 7, total currently available is 3. 10 minus 7. Then like that B, total 5 instances were there. Out of 5, 1 allocated, 1 plus 1, 2 allocated. So 5 minus 2 is 3. Then C, total 7 instances were there. Out of 7, 2 plus 1 plus 2, 5 is allotted. So 7 minus 5 is currently available. C is 2. This is the current scenario. Now we are going to apply Bangor's algorithm. So I told you there are two parts for a Bangor's algorithm: safety algorithm and resource request algorithm. So first you have to check whether the current scenario is a safe state or not. For that we are applying the safety algorithm. The same thing whatever I explained is here. Then safety algorithm is, see, here P0, P1, P2, P3, P4, right? And P0 required 7 A's, 743. We don't have 743. We have only 3A, 3B. Don't read it as 332 or don't read it as 743. 7A, 4B, 3C. 3A, 3B, 2C. Individual digit by digit you have to read it. So 7A, P0 required to complete the task. We don't have. We have only 3. Here P1 required 1A, 2B, 2C. We have, right? We have 3A, 3B, 2Cs are there. So we can satisfy P1's need. So P1 give resources to P1. So P1 required 1, 2, 2. Their need is 1, 2, 2. We are giving that need. P1 allocated with the 3, 2, 2. Whatever maximum they required, we allocated. Now current available is 210. 332 were there. Out of 332, I given 122. So 3 minus 1 is 2. 3 minus 2 is 1. 2 minus 2 is 0. So it is 210. Currently available is 210. And P1 completed the task, right? So P1 got whatever they required. So they can do their work. They completed the task. After the completion, see, Now only 5 is allocated and total was 10, right? So current available is 5. Only 2 Bs are allocated. Total Bs were 5. So 5 minus 2 is 3. Total 5 Cs are allocated. Total C 7s were there. So 7 minus 5 is 2. This is the available. 7. We need P0 needs 7. We don't have 7 A's. P1, P2. P1 completed the task. P2. P2 required only 6A. We don't have. 6A's we don't have. So we can't do P2 also. Next one is P3. P3 required only 1B and 1C. We have enough resources, right? 1B, 1C we have. So you can give resources to P3. So we are going to give resources to P3. So P3 will be 222. Currently available is 521. After getting the maximum whatever they want, they will be completing the task. After the completion of task, they will be releasing the resources to currently available set. So now currently available set is 743. Now we are in the P3, right? You have to go in the order. So next one is 431. For P4 required 4A, 3B, 1C. Do you have 4A, 3B, 1C? Yes, we have. So give the resources to P4. P4 got all the available resources. So the current available is 312. After getting the maximum resources, P4 will be completing their task. After their task, they will be releasing the resources to the current available set. Now, so far 3 process completed the task, P1, P3, P4. Now P0 and P2. So 743600, right? So see, P2 required only 6. We have 6, so P2 will be getting all the resources, and after getting all the resources, they will be completing the task. Now after completing the task, they will be releasing the resources back to P0, and P0 required only 7A, 4B, 3C. Do you have? Yes, we have 10 A's are there, 4 B's are, 7 C's are there. We have enough resources. So give that resources to P0. P0 will be getting all the resources, and current available is 304. After getting the maximum resources here, P0 will be completing the task. After task completing the task, they will be releasing the resources back to the available set. So from this we will be understanding, you are able to produce the safe sequence. What is the safe sequence? First you have to execute P1, then P3, then P4, then P2, then P0. So this is the sequence. If you go for this sequence, you will not be in the deadlock. So it is in the safe state. So this is the first part of the Banger's algorithm, and the next part is I'll be explaining in the next video. I hope all of you understood. So we are checking whether the current scenario is producing safe sequence or not. We applied the safety algorithm I explained in the last video. Based on the safety algorithm, I will be able to produce this safe sequence. First is execute P1, then P3, then P4, then P2, then P0. All process executed. If you go for this sequence, you will not be there in the deadlock state. Thank you all. And the second part I'll be explaining in the next video.